Greetings and salutations, friends. Welcome back to Dawgs TV. I'm your host, Joe McFarland. This is the third and final installment of the series we're entitling the Coaches Roundtable, or the Road Table, because, I mean, let's face it, they're all out on the road, scattered across North America, coaching for the here and now, but also getting ready for the 2021 Western Canadian Baseball League season. Joining us now via Zoom is head coach Mitch Schmidt, as well as assistant coaches Dave Robb, Andy Peterson, and Joe Sergent. Let's get back to the conversation now.
Let's get into the potential lineup that you may end up seeing and maybe some guys that are on your radars right now. And Andy, let's start with you. Who's kind of caught your eye thus far, albeit maybe from a distance, guys who might be able to crack a lineup starting in 2021, should it happen?
Yep. So I think the best way to start, we got three middle infielders coming back from that championship team. We got Richie Mascarenhas, who's at Oregon State, Liam Riella, the Thompson River, and then Ricardo Sanchez, who's, you know, one of the best players the Academy has had in a pretty long time. So, I mean, just starting off with those three guys coming back, three spark plugs, three great teammates, three workers, all that kind of stuff, you know, you can't really go wrong. I know we got a couple other guys coming in that are going to have that big impact right away, but, you know, obviously knowing that we got those few guys coming back, so pretty easy weight on my shoulders, at least, you know.
Mm-hmm. Dave, from a hitting perspective, do you got anybody that you really are excited for Dawgs fans to see next season?
No, I don't know a whole lot of the kids on the team. So, or the recruiting kids, these guys are all keeping to themselves, and we haven't had a meeting in a long time. We're actually going to do something here, next little while, but you know, if we get some of the players that are coming back, so you've got the Mascarenhas, so the Liam Riella, they were both all, you know, all stars, and I think Gavin Logan is probably coming back. He was an all star type. He brought a huge double in the finals, in the final game. And then Ricardo's just going to get that much better. So, you know, you kind of have a good nucleus right there. And I know that Mitch has been, you know, recruiting like crazy with some guys that are really, really impact kinds of hitters. You know, for the most part, like I say, I haven't done, I'm hoping that I can contact some of the kids that were at Mesa that were sophomores, that were, you know, that had signed for last year, and one of them is an infielder that can hit, and but I haven't had any word from him yet, you know, as for next year, because and that's the other thing, is that some of these kids going on, their coaches may want them to go certain places, so I have to get back in touch with them. But they come in, and then we kind of set what we want to do with them, and then I just kind of stay out of their way and let them do what they do best.
I want to keep you on for a second, just because you've been here before, you've been that reigning champion. When it comes to the hitting side of the game, do you have sort of in your mind how you'd like things to play out in terms of making sure that you up the ante from the previous season?
Well, when we have players come in, you get to know them, you know, because they're all playing from different programs in different schools, and sometimes they're teaching different things, and so, you know, we have to kind of find that happy medium with them. You know, I'm really, and Mitch is the same thing, we're very big on hitting the ball in the middle of the field and hitting line drives, that the ball that carries out is going to be, or that carries over their heads and things, that'll all come. And that there's got to be contact first. So some of the guys that we had last year, but the last couple of years, you know, they were kind of swing and miss guys, and they didn't play a whole lot until, you know, at the very end when we lost so many players. So you get a Jackson Volk, who was just an outstanding hitter, and he contacted, he didn't strike out that much. And he used the middle of the field, he hit the ball the opposite field, and we lose him to the end of the season. And so now we have to play somebody else in that position who we wouldn't have played otherwise. So, you know, contact is going to be huge. We take bunt rounds all the time in our batting practice, and we do bunt. And when you go to the seventh, eighth, ninth inning, the extra innings and things like that, bunting is going to be important. So we've got to play the game that way too. You just can't have, guys come in and say, okay, well, you know, just go ahead and hack away and do what you do, you know, at your school with a metal bat, you know, 16 home runs or 20 home runs with a metal bat doesn't equate to 16 to 20 home runs of the wood bat if you're going to do the same thing. So we kind of have to find that medium, happy medium with them. And kind of, there is some teaching involved. Sometimes some are a little bit slower to get it than others. They just, because they refuse, they don't want to change. They want to just get their reps in. So some of it is, you know, identifying them and working with them a little bit, getting their ear a little bit and find out. But it's mostly basic baseball. It's, you know, we've got to move guys, we've got to score guys. Ground balls work. They score a lot of runs. You know, strikeouts don't score a whole lot of runs. So, you know, we those are things that we have to impress on them.
From a pitching perspective, Joe, anybody catching your eye so far?
I think the biggest thing is just our kind of our core guys, like because I mean we lost Hamburger and Simpson last year, kind of our leaders on the mound and stuff like that, and with Desjardins at the back, and you know they're all seniors, so moving forward I think we're going to rely mostly kind of on our nucleus with like Bruner and Spearing and guys who can really give some innings, and we're hoping Ruff can come back from his injury and Townsend can come back from his injury. So I think like those guys, if we can get those guys going, we know what we got out of them. So we know we have, you know, four legit starters that can go out there and give us a chance to win every single night. And then you start adding in some guys, some senior arms. Like we heard of a couple of guys out in Cologne, out in Okanagan with Hummel and Brown. Those two guys, top end arms in the league out there. In the Canadian League. So, you know, we have a really good relationship with our head guy. So he's been able to kind of give us our best arms lately, you know, especially with the way we were able to have Tadasichuk, our center fielder, 2 years ago, kind of giving us the green light out there, like say, hey, you know, this is a good place to go. So I think he's like, we're going to give you the best arms possible. So I'm excited to kind of see those guys. And then, you know, the American guys that are coming up, you know, it's always a very touchy subject with pitching, especially with college guys, just because, you know, you don't know how many innings they throw, you know, they throw X amount of innings and then next thing you know, and you're counting on them in mid-May and they're like, oh yeah, by the way, I'm shut down. So we got a good plan in place that we've been talking about, you know, and we're going to hope it kind of pays off this year for us. But I think if we have our nucleus going, I think we're going to be really good again this year. I don't know.
I'll leave the final word to Mitch here. As you look ahead to 2021, what are you looking forward to the most?
I'm looking forward to going up and having some fun and getting another ring. There's, you know, what a lot of people don't realize is DR, Dana, his wife, and Andy and I, we all live together, you know, and obviously Joe, you know, we spend a lot of time together. We're a family, a big family, and we have a common goal. We're going to win this thing. You know, DR's been there. We want to make sure that there's a ring on every single finger on DR's hand.
That's four.
That's what this is about. And here's the deal. We have a lot of fun. And because we have a lot of fun, it keeps the guys having fun. And the fans, they see it. They respect it. We play the game right. We play the game hard. And they know, you know, they'll see it. You know, every one of the coaches on this staff, if we see a guy on the Dawgs loafing it, Andy's going to get in him. Joe's going to get in him. DR is going to get in him. I'm going to. And there's a pretty good chance that John's going to be up in the cheap seats. He's going to be yelling. So, but what I'm looking forward is coming up and having fun. It's the Andy's a junior college head coach in the States. DR, you know, he's with Mesa. He's an assistant coach, but they're a very storied program. Our jobs, you know, and obviously me at Bellevue, and then Joe, hey. If we don't win, if the Dawgs don't win, me, DR, and Andy, we go home And we don't hear it. We don't hear it for, you know, 9 months. But Joe hears it left, right, center, behind, you know, and just gets fed it. Just gets fed it. You losers. You losers. Okeechobees. You know, mm-hmm. It's important for us to win. But if we do our job, we're going to win. And the players are going to be relaxed. Hey, we're good to go. That's what I'm looking forward to the most. And then I'm actually going to touch on something else as far as the rosters. What's happening right now is a lot of colleges are not getting guys committed to summer ball right now because they don't know what's going on with their seasons. Mm-hmm. NCAA, they don't know. Realistically, Division II and Division III NCAA, they do know. Junior college, they're even talking about, you know, because obviously Andy's in the NWAC. You know your actual start date. So some of the NWAC kids are getting pushed out. But NJCAA, DR, you guys have basically been told that January 15th you can start, correct?
Right.
So that's there. But what's happened also is you have some of the conferences like Region 9, which is some of the junior colleges here in Nebraska and Iowa. They said that they're not going to – they basically told the coaches, you may have your schedule, but that schedule is probably not going to be what it is because we're going to wait until later on to tell you when you are going to be able to start. And they're actually talking about pushing back their regionals and stuff where they're not talking about pushing back the World Series, but they're taking that one extra week and they're cutting some of the games out of the northern schools – because they feel that the northern schools are on buses and planes and stuff more and have a higher chance of catching COVID. So we'll see what happens. It'll be interesting.
Well, I'm sure there are a lot of fans out there that are very excited about the possibility of baseball returning here in this province before too long. Gentlemen, appreciate your times. Thank you so much for joining us here and looking forward to what 2021 has in store for us.
Thank you, Joe.
Thanks, go Joe. Dawgs.
Go Dawgs, go.
Go Dawgs, go.
And thanks to all of you for checking out this series. We hope you've enjoyed hearing from the coaches and getting a little bit of insight into what they've been up to since we last saw them on the field back in 2019. To catch up on all of the previous episodes, head on over to dawgsbaseball.ca. We'll see you next time here on Dawgs TV.